Hello, this is Solar Business TV from Sitges Solar from Brazil. And we are with the founder of Sitges, with Leonardo Curioni. But today we don't speak about Sitges because we just spoke about the company with Lucas, who was following us around the world. But now with Leonardo, we'll be speaking about Solar Business Club. So, Leonardo, buongiorno, hello,
buongiorno, hello, buon dia, boa tarde, buon noite.
Leonardo, we spent some time now on organizing our common event, which we organize next week, Solar Future Today Forum Latin America, and also launch of Solar Business Club.
Yeah.
And actually, it's very interesting because you are Italiano, vero, yes, and also Brazilian person here in the country, and one of the most successful entrepreneurs in solar and clean tech industry. And I would like to ask you, Leonardo, from your point of view, so you are like, let's say, connecting both cultures, yes,
yeah.
European and Brazilian. How you imagine Solar Business Club here in Brazil? And if you bring some of your experience from Europe, and also connected and compared to the Brazilian experience.
We understand this kind of market because of our history in Europe, first in Italy, then in Europe, then a little bit in the United States, and we started in 2013 in Brazil. And we create this kind of distributed generation market. And since the beginning, we saw that there's a space in order to understand better the culture behind the scenes of just selling solar and photovoltaic systems. And this kind of culture, it's a way of life that the sustainable energy, sustainable world, we have to implement also in Latin America, and it's very important to reach this common goal. So I really believe that one of the best things we can do right now, it's to make this kind of club for all the people, CEOs, directors, or entrepreneurs who wants to create, who wants to be protagonism in this kind of revolution. We have to focus also as human beings and not just thinking as competitive or just customers and the suppliers, but it's very important to have a conscience, a common sense, a common goal we have to reach, making brainstorming, sharing ideas, make everyone who wants to obtain more than just business to be part of club and developing 100% sustainable culture.
Because we organize, you know, a lot of dinners, events around the world, yes? And what we understood on other continents that we are still at the very beginning of our journey, yes? And there is a lot of actually work to do, and actually we should more focus maybe on the growing the cake than just, you know, trying to get the small piece of
some
this.
Pieces. The cake is small right now. Mm-hmm. So if you want to make this cake bigger and bigger, we have to think at the commons goal that everyone has to reach. But because of the disruption, every small company, every small pieces in this kind of economy, and in the, especially in renewable energy in Latin America, have been very good places in this.
I think, Leonardo, that you remember this picture, yes?
Yeah, absolutely.
With three levels, yes?
Yes.
So business.
Every level is important, yes. Not just business, not just politics, not just financing, but it's a cooperation between all the players in this kind of market. A common goal that there is the 100% renewable, the 100% solar culture, the 100% sustainability program for everyone, because capitalism say to us, oh, you have just to consume, but okay, I consume, and what about the other values, the other things, the raw materials that we are using, the plastic we are producing, where is this kind of plastic once we don't use them?
So actually you are now referring to our slogan of Solar Business Club, which means business, meaningfulness, and joy.
Absolutely. You have not just to work for money or for yourself. You have to be very happy to cooperate for our planet, sharing these ideas to all the people in a country, in Latin America, etc.
And make it with joy.
Absolutely, because this joy inside your soul making this good for the planet and not
because actually, just... you know what we discovered also that we are actually blessed like an industry, yes? Because we can make business, we can make money, but also while making business, we are contributing to the better world.
And to the air.
But at the end of the day, we can also make with joy, yes? Like we have dinners, we have black tie gala, we are dancing together, enjoying the time.
It's not just a networking or just a dinner that many competitors or entrepreneurs go, but please try to share ideas, discuss the same goal. Your goal could be the same goal of your competitor. And if you find the right way in order to reach more easy, etc., everyone will be winning on this. The market is big and there's space for everyone. No one is, because of this disrupting culture, it's a nonsense to have monopoly because the disruption culture is against the monopoly. For
exactly, because already even the Brazilian market is growing, it's still maybe 1 gigawatt, yes?
Yeah, it's
and it will be in the future hundreds of gigawatts.
Yes, absolutely. The market in Brazil, we have 250 million people, more or less, like United States, but United States 100 million more. But it's a very huge market. It's a very huge country. It's very big. And different, the states are very different one of other. So also the values, the thinkings, the minds are very different. So there's space for everyone. Mm-hmm. There's space for everyone.
So how will be organize the structure and how we gonna invite other people to come? So I think that it's important, yes, that we create this like a trustful club, yes?
A trust network between different players in the market who wants to make something different and want themselves to be active to make this change true and possible. And not just, okay, I pay an association, then I sit and I do nothing. No, we need the cooperation, we need the people, we need ideas. Mm-hmm. And discussing these ideas in order to then speak with associations, speak with everyone. But we are just focusing on networking and to sharing ideas, not making any politics, not making any cartel, not making anything just based on economics.
On our picture, yes, you saw there is one empowering initiatives, yes? So one of the empowering initiatives will be empowering leaders, yes? So which means that we would like to help the leaders from, being like a leaders of small niche industry to become leaders of the big industries, yes? Mm-hmm. So which means we would like to help them in communication,
everything,
public speaking trainings, and maybe also management of stress, yes? Because when we start the disruption, there will be more and more stressful situations and changing situation.
Yes, are many, many things we have to do with the club. We can offering coaching for entrepreneur, for example, sharing experience of the biggest one with the entrepreneur that are just entering on this and sharing the knowledge.
So you are not afraid to share your knowledge with new entrants?
We have to. One of the focus and the pillar point of CICES since the beginnings, we started in 2013 and 14, training people, training entrepreneurs, training the first companies who believe that solar...
Even they can be your competitor.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. But we invested free of charge this kind of trainings. And we spent. I spent literally the first 3 years I were in Brazil to make this kind of training for entrepreneurs, for companies, for people who want to understand more of solar. And right now they become customers but also competitors. Because who is the winner on the competition? The final customer. And the final customer in solar is the one who decide to build his own solar system on the roof of his house. So if the prices will be the lower on the market, we can create and get in the market bigger and bigger. So the competition have not to be just on prices, etc., but ideas, the insurance, the ideas of a value service, adding something and not just products. You have to provide values because selling product, everyone is good. but you have to provide also services, also ideas, also something new, special, that could fidelize your customer, fidelize your clients. This is the secret of every business, not just the solar one. So we can make this kind of coaching for people who wants to make something great for other people, for other economies, for other entrepreneurs. And Brazil is one of the most difficult country to make business. So if one Italian reached this kind of point and situation, I would like to share with someone else who wants to learn. So for me, it will be
and
a great
also
honor.
In the Solar Business Club, we will not only exchange the knowledge within Brazil, yes, but we will bring
Latin
the knowledge
America,
from Latin America and from other countries.
From the other country, we experience all around the world. Absolutely.
Okay. So last thing, Leonardo, because you are very busy, yes, not only with your business, but also with our events, with preparation to InterSolar. So just very shortly, what is our plan, let's say, for next week? Yes. So first we have Solar Future today. We are launching Solar Business Club. And then all the people who would like to join the club, they can also visit you on your booth, yes?
Yes, absolutely. InterSolar will be there 28th, 9th and 30th of August, also with you, Thomas, I think. Mm-hmm. And if someone want to know much more, we will present in a panel in InterSolar.
On the 30th of August?
Yes, we will launch officially the club in Brazil for Latin America, not just Brazil, remember. And we will explain how we'll works.
Okay, so thank you so much.
Obrigado. Obrigado todo mundo. Thank you, Thomas. Thank you.
How is your Portuguese? Can you say something in Portuguese, you know?
Portuguese é normal para mim, que dia a dia no Brasil você tem que aprender a falar português perfeitamente, né?
Okay, so next time also I hope that I will be able to speak like Leonardo.
Let's
so
see.
In 2019, yes?
Let's see.
Okay. Grazie mille.
This is a challenge.
Obrigado.
Thank you very much for your visit. Thumbs up for solar.